live forever. We pray that we will always receive Jesus with love. So, with hearts full of joy and love, we welcome our dear parents, guests, and friends to this Eucharistic celebration. Please turn off your electronic devices and focus on God's calling. Please stand and join us in singing our gathering song.
Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people.
Lord,
have mercy.
Lord,
that rejoicing at how your love has been allotted to us, we may merit to be numbered among the elect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, ever and ever.
Amen.
From the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up and
said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In this world that is going crazier and crazier, because there are some powers in the world that are fighting for more power, and they want to get rid of the other power so they can get more power, power of money, power of all these things that you can buy for more power, the media, all these. I want to buy this platform. I don't want to name it because we are getting recorded. This platform of this internet, this one and this one, so they can make their own reality. And now another instrument of power is laboratories, medicines, hospitals, and I don't know, they are manipulating humanity. They have their own plans. They have their own plans. Plans everywhere. Plans of the right party, plans of the left party, plans of the different groups out there, the LGBT, something like that. It has its own plan. Feminism has its own plan. All these, I don't know, too many things happening out there. They have their own plans. If they want to conquer you, to add up to his plan, to their plans. But I want to tell you something. We are Christians. And you know what? Jesus has his own plan. And the best plan is Jesus's. Why? Because the plan of Jesus is, never better said, out of this world. The plan of Jesus is out of this world. He's the only one that can offer a plan out of this world. Why? Because he conquered death. Nobody will stay in this world. Nobody. Nobody can deny. This is a truth that no plans in this world account on that. We would all die.
Everybody will die. And only Jesus Christ has the plan out of this world. He's the only one that his plans break through the barrier of death. Isn't that amazing? And you know what? He's the only one that people out there is attacking. They're crazy. He is the only one that has a plan, the best plan for humanity. For humanity. And that's why I can see and I can believe that we have enemies out there, but not enemies that are human people. No. Enemies that are worse than that. Spiritual enemies that are making crazy people. Enemies against Jesus, against God, against his plans, so they can conquer humanity and destroy humanity. And they are doing it. We can see now. The thing is, Jesus did something quietly, but powerful. You see, the power of God is quiet. He's really quiet because God doesn't need to make war. He doesn't need to make noise. God doesn't need to defend his power. Why? Because nobody can take the power of God out from him. Nobody can take him out. Do you see these flowers here? All these beautiful flowers. Can a human being can do this? No. These flowers are alive. And God is the only one that has the authority to give life. To kill is too easy. But to give life, only God has the power to give life. And when you go out and you see all these trees, all these plants full of life, it's noisy, the power of God. It's quiet. It's fresh. Gives peace. All the powers, they make his presence known with noise. And we need to understand the plan of God. This is very important. Sometimes I ask Catholic people, do you know what is the plan of God? You say, no. And then I ask them, are you Catholic? If you don't know the plan of God, what's the plan of your life? You're a Christian because it is supposed that you know the plan of God revealed by Jesus Christ, and you accept the plan of Jesus Christ for your life, and you don't know what's his plan? Well, in a few words, I will let you know now what is his plan. And it's amazing. Jesus Christ, he came to this world making himself human. So divinity came to this world knocking the door of a very beautiful young lady that she was talking to him, and until she was sure that this angel came from God, then she answered, let it be done to me according to his word. So she said yes to God. So now in her very womb, in a little place like a cell, like a single cell in his womb, God became human. Then he began to grow in a mother's womb, the mother of God, a human God. And then he began to reveal things, the plan of God. He is a totally new thing that happened in the whole history of the universe. A God is human, and a human is God. And he came to offer to every human being an invitation. Do you want to share with the Most Holy Trinity? Do you know who is the Most Holy Trinity? Who's the Most Holy Trinity? Who knows? Raise your hand. Who is the Most Holy Trinity? Yeah.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Exactly. Sometimes Catholics, they forget basic things. Okay? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Son, the second person of the Most Holy Trinity, became human. But he's part of God. But he's not a part, because God, you cannot divide God. Even though you can see how these three different personalities is one God. Whatever the Son is the Father and the Holy Spirit. Whatever the Father is the Son and the Holy Spirit. Whatever the Holy Spirit is the Son and the Father. So, if the Son was in the womb of Mary, there was the Most Holy Trinity. Wherever the Son is the Father and the Holy Spirit. And Jesus said that. Whatever sees me, sees the Father. So now this God is human. And he's knocking doors to each one of us, because he doesn't want to impose his divinity. We need to open the door. We open the door to divinity. And we need to say yes to Jesus Christ so he can come. And it's not a possession. Of course not. He doesn't take out my free will, my mind, my creativity, my talents. I want to put in practice. I need to put in practice all my talents and my freedom and my creativity to join the will of God, to be one with God. So, remember the gospel today? Love each other as I have loved you. When we learn to love like Jesus loved us, you know, Jesus came to pay for us. This is very important. You children that are going to take communion, this has to be a lot with what you are doing today. Jesus came to pay a price for me. What is the value of the life of Jesus? You can put, you know, imagine a scale. A scale, okay? In a plate, you can put all the universe. You can put all the galaxies. All those galaxies of thousand light years in the space. Planets, suns, you can put all the galaxies we know. You know that how big are those galaxies? This little planet, is a part of a solar system, then this solar system is a part of a galaxy, and this galaxy is huge. Imagine that. And it's the smaller galaxy of this part of the universe that we know. There are many other galaxies. How big is the power of the powers of this world? Just a little sand, okay? You put all those galaxies in the plate of the scale. And in the other plate, you put the Son of God. That's the value of Jesus. Jesus paid for us, for you and for me. He paid for us. And he didn't pay with a sun, with a planet, with a galaxy. No, he paid with his life, with himself. He gave himself to pay for us. So a Christian is a person that accepts that price for me, so I can be raised, redeemed by him. Have you heard, my little children, have you heard out there this sentence that is a total lie? My body is my body, and I will do with my body whatever I want with my body. That's a big lie, especially for Christians. If you are a Christian, you will never say my body is my body, because my body belongs to Jesus. And I do with my body whatever Jesus asked me to do with my body. And what does Jesus ask me to do? Love each other as I have loved you. He doesn't say love each other the way the TV tells you. He didn't say love each other as your friend tells you how to love him. No. As I loved him. And he didn't use sex to love us. He didn't use it. He used his body in a totally different way to be understanding, to be patient, to forgive, to be generous. He didn't use his body to be rich. He didn't use his body for pleasure. No. Love each other as I have loved. And now, the best thing is, when he was killed, everybody rejected him, and he was killed. He was, the world get rid of Jesus Christ. And when they thought that they got rid of him, he raised. He appeared again only for all those that love him. Do you love Jesus Christ? Do you believe in the Eucharist? The apostles touch Jesus Christ after resurrection. That flesh was new, a new flesh, a new body, a body that will never die, a body that will never get old. You see all these dreams of humanity, like this story in the mall? Forever 21. Yeah, you wish. You wish to be forever 21. There is only one human being that already is young forever. Mary. What is the medicine that you can take to raise from the dead. The Eucharist. The Eucharist, my little children, the one that you are going to take today. Today. If you believe in Jesus Christ, after you take communion, you will never repeat that sentence out there. My body is my body. No. My body belongs to Jesus. Every time you take communion, you are repeating that. Jesus, your body is mine and my body is yours. That's it. I will never do with my body something that insults you. Never. The world is telling me to do that, but I will never do it. All those parties, left and right, all those groups out there, they are telling me to do this, to do that, to do that. They will never take me out of the tomb. God is the only one that can do it. Jesus is the only one that can do it. When you receive communion, remember that. Receiving communion, receiving the body of Jesus, that means that I accept in my life the price that Jesus paid for me. Taking communion means that. I accept in my mind, in my heart, in my soul, I accept the price that Jesus paid for me. I will never do with my body something that insults Jesus, something against the plan of Jesus Christ. And we know that the plan of God is the best for me. The only plan that is literally out of this world. Okay? So, well, let us continue with this amazing Eucharist, with this amazing celebration. As we take part in this first Eucharist celebration, we remember that we are unworthy to receive the Lord. But it's only because of God's goodness and love for us that we are invited to his table. He gave us a share in his life on the day we were baptized. He now calls us to renew and strengthen that life by sharing the body and blood of his Son in the Holy Eucharist. We now wish to ask these children to renew the promises made for them on the day of their baptism. So please, my dear children, stand up. Okay, my dear children, do you believe in God, our loving Father, in his Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, and the Holy Spirit? Do you believe everything which our Holy Catholic Church believes and teaches?
I do believe.
Do you promise to avoid evil and to live in faith for Jesus?
I do promise.
Do you promise to look for God's goodness everywhere around you and to believe that God always cares for you?
I do promise.
Do you promise to try to live always?
Bishops and priests,
that they may be blessed as they help us know the Lord better and grow in holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the first holy communicants, that we may be the happiness and joy of our parents and of all who know us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who will receive Jesus for the first time, that we may grow more like him every day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parents and our families, that unity and harmony may reign in our homes. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered today, that in our daily life and work, we may be witness of the gospel in serving God and neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God and Father, you have called us here together as one family. Listen to our prayers. Help us to live more and more for you and to do everything with your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Now please be seated as we present our offering. In these offerings that this lady is bringing, we receive the fruits of your work, sacrifice that will be one in the sacrifice of Jesus. Father, receive the fruit of the hands of your people, so they can receive back from your holy deliverance. Pray with me that my sacrifice of yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands with the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive, Holy Father, this offering of our humility, which we bring you with joy as we commemorate the resurrection day. In gratitude,
pray that it may be for us, who are joined to the sacrifice of Christ, our consolation on earth and our eternal salvation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift it up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise you, mighty deeds, in the exaltation of all the saints. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for your eternal shepherd do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those who have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this." Risen Lord Jesus Christ, be with us. Let us proclaim this mystery of our faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Father, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son's death and resurrection, we offer you this bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Look now on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
You take away.
Hallelujah.